Greetings, my fellow music lovers. Long time no video, but it is for a good reason. For the last 6 months, I've been busy working on version 2 of Scale Workshop, and I'm happy to announce that we finally got it published with Savage. Now that I've dealt with the first bug reports, it's time to make some tutorials. Let's start with 12 tonical temperament and go over the basic interface. If you're on a desktop computer, you can use the keyboard to make sound. By default, the layout is isomorphic, which means that chords always have the same shape. Major chords have this shape, while minor chords have this shape. You can quickly jump in octaves by pressing the asterisk or slash keys on your numpad. If you don't have a numpad on your keyboard, don't worry, you can change the keyboard shortcuts here. You can also change the isomorphic mapping. Let's make the horizontal axis be whole tones, and the vertical axis be minor thirds. We can also use a more familiar piano style arrangement, like this. A nice natural minor scale. Or we can have two courses, like this. To sustain notes, use the Shift key. To release notes, press them again, or press the key next to number 1 on your keyboard. If you're on a mobile device, you can use the virtual keyboard in isomorphic mode, or with a piano style arrangement. To change the waveform, select it here. We have traditional stuff like sine waves, sawtooths, or triangle waves, or even a semisine, which is the default. We also have special waveforms, like this one here, which I think goes quite well with 12 tonical temperament. By the way, some elements disable the keyboard, so if I tap my way here, you can see the status here. And now if I press the T key, it selects the triangle waveform, instead of playing anything. You can change the envelope by clicking these presets. Or by manipulating the sliders manually. You can increase or decrease the maximum polyphony here. More voices require more processing power from your device. If you hear pops while playing, you can reduce them here. Adjust the slider until the pops go away. Finally, if you prefer a color scheme that is easier on the eyes, you can select it here. Thank you for watching! If you'd like to support the development of Scale Workshop, you can do so at patreon.com/frostburn. Or you can support our designer Savish at ko-fi.com/savish. Scale Workshop is open source. If you'd like to join our development team drop us a line at GitHub or join Sevice's Discord server. See you next time when we learn how to design scales together.